The Haymarket Clinic looks after people who can't look after themselves.
The clinic is more than a medical centre, it's a place where people can get their lives back on track.
I don't see the purpose in closing the place down. They can spend all this money on war and bullshit and stupid street decorations, but what about the homeless? We are people too. Curtain up the performer, ready for the camera's aim. Float
light like a feather on the pad to fame the same. In the 70s, the Haymarket was a pretty depressed part of the city. Large numbers of homeless, some with mental health problems, some with alcohol problems. Not a great part of town, but a great part of town to provide services to the homeless. I'm Dr. Gavin Frost. I started working in the Haymarket caravan in 1974. I've worked with the Haymarket Clinic for the best part of 20 years. It was originally formed by Dr. Charles Blower. He had a commitment to services to the homeless because the emergency department was not a welcoming place for the great unwashed, the homeless, the drug affected, the alcohol affected. As far as I can tell, we're just about where the van used to park. It just seemed like the right place. The city council provided a caravan which we could park here. And so the nurse, the doctor and the social worker were in the van from 4 till 10 every night. When the queues at the van were still long at 10 o'clock at closing time at night, Charles Blower realised that we needed a base in the city. The clinic's been providing a service since 1974, more than 41 years now, to the homeless people of Sydney.
Homelessness in Australia is far more of a problem than it should be given the relative wealth of the country. Homelessness in New South Wales, the 2011 census showed there was over 20,000 people who are homeless. You can attend the Haymarket Clinic without a Medicare card, and they'll provide a service regardless of the situation they're in. As far as we're aware, there's nothing available in Australia that's like the Haymarket Clinic, and in fact probably around the world.
My name's Brandon Watson. Been homeless on and off for the last 4 years. You need Medicare, healthcare, all that sort of shit to go to a doctor. You go to Haymarket, they can just do a general checkup on you, help you with your medication. And I say, oh, I've got bipolar disorder as well, and sometimes it's good just to have someone to talk to.
Dr. Michael Clark's a colleague. I may have even interviewed him for the job, and he's been working there for quite some time, an outstanding model of the sort of doctor who looks after these people.
The clinic sees roughly about 75 people a day. Drug and alcohol issues are huge. Mental illness is huge. Chaotic lifestyle is huge. They're the type of clients that we have. There's no doubt you can make better money in private practice, but it's a privilege to be able to give something back to people who are neglected by the rest of society, people who don't have a voice.
Each year, the Haymarket Foundation Clinic has received $900,000 of federal funding. We calculate very conservatively that there's at least $1.8 million of value to the community on that $900,000 grant. The federal grant from the Department of Health has ended, therefore the clinic will have no money to continue beyond that.
I'm personally devastated. As I say, I've worked here a long time. I'm absolutely horrified.
Unlike many other groups in society, the homeless really don't have a voice, and they're not likely to rise up and support the clinic, even though, of course, individually they would. I think anyone who's ever been associated with the clinic believes it's a very important addition to the services for marginalised and homeless people in Sydney.
My name is Mark. I've been living it rough for a couple of years now down here, and just don't close down the Haymarket, mate. Been going there for a couple of years now. Get me mail sent there because I've got my homeless. I don't know where I'm going to get my mail sent to now when they shut down. I'll have to find somewhere.
My name's Stephen. I've been homeless for approximately 25 years. These people, like myself, have got nowhere to go.
There's no facilities for the ladies to have a shower, except for Haymarket or Wayside Chapel. But Haymarket's only just up there, so quick walk.
The biggest risk to the patients that come here when we close is that their medical care will become virtually non-existent. If people are not seen and followed up, at worst, they will have mental health issues, having psychotic episodes in the street because they're not having mental health checks. People not having medical checks, and at worst, can die in the streets.
That's a real concern for us, is without this clinic here, there will be patients who won't receive a service. they'll end up in emergency department in a chronic state, and these costs are now going to need to be borne by other parts of the community. We've sought a meeting with Minister Susan Ley to talk about the funding for the Foundation Clinic, and as yet we've had no response from her office.
The Feed contacted the Federal Health Minister Susan Ley last week and was told, "We are working with the Haymarket Foundation to ensure their financial future and long-term sustainability." However, the Haymarket Foundation said they had not heard anything from anyone in the health department. On Tuesday, we went back to Susan Ley to clarify this discrepancy. Yesterday, we spoke with the Haymarket Clinic, who said they had finally received a call from Susan Ley's department and that they are now in talks to secure their funding.
Homeless people die about 20 years earlier than the normal population, so not having health services may mean, particularly in winter, that people get very ill, and yes, they may die. It's really up to homelessness organisations, peaks such as ourselves, and the general community to really fight for these services, because homeless people, they're busy looking after themselves and getting through the day, so they don't have time or the ability really to fight the services that they may be using.
From what I worked out, spending so much time on and off the street for the last few years, it's like the resources for the homeless, it's very limited as it is. If you got nothing, you get nothing. Could you imagine being on the street, not being able to get your mail anyway? You get cut off Centrelink, you're screwed. At the moment, I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm just hoping God slaps me in the face with an option.